Good evening. Welcome to our state orchestra contest concert preview concert. I knew I was going to mess that up. Welcome and thanks for coming tonight. We have some very high-level music making for you tonight. I hope you enjoy the little blurb I wrote about what it is that we're doing next weekend and why it's so important and how it helps, not defines, but helps define our year. We're going to get started with String Sinfonia this evening with Rhythmos. Thanks again. Great start. Nice job, String Sinfonia. Next, if you're wondering where the warm weather came from this week, it's the next tune, all of our rehearsing on this. That's us. We did it for you. You're welcome. We'll continue with When the Summer Comes. Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to introduce again Miss Driscoll. Her and I co-teach this class, and she's going to conduct the last tune.
Thank you. Okay. So that was our Symphonia group. One more round of applause for them. It was amazing. I am so excited to hear how they do when we go to contest 2 Saturdays from now. But now we're going to do one of my favorite traditions of the entire year, middle school or high school. We have this chamber orchestra, which is a bunch of middle schoolers who audition to get into an honors type of group. And we rehearse here at the high school. It's both Shore and Memorial students from 7th and 8th grade. We rehearse once a week for an hour on Tuesdays. And we always play side by side with Mannheim on this concert. And I think the kids don't realize how cool it is until like literally right now when they're getting on stage and they're like, oh no, this is like a high school audience and we're sitting with high schoolers. So we're gonna reset the stage a little bit. We're gonna bring out a ton of kids and our middle schoolers are gonna get to play with our Mannheim kids in just a second.
Thank you. Good evening. As many of you may know, Mannheim has traditionally gone to Youngstown State University over the summer for about 5 days to play what we're going to play over the year, and we've been conducted by Dr. Gage. As some of you may also know, Dr. Gage was in critical condition for a while, and he recently passed away. Though some of us only knew him for those 5 days, he very quickly became more than just our teacher. He became a mentor and a very close friend. A loss like this is certainly a very difficult one. It's especially a great loss to those who know him and indeed to the entire world. So tonight, we're going to play this concert in the honor and memory of Dr. Stephen Gage. Thank you.
This is way more mic time than I'm comfortable with, just so you know. Sorry. Two quick other things. One of us doesn't look like the rest. They lost my tux at the dry cleaners. It's not on purpose. It's not a thing. I will wear the tux next week when I hopefully get it back. Two, you may have read in the program underneath this particular piece in the midst of our program tonight. We're going to be playing the entire string serenade by Elgar this evening. So there are three specific sections. There is a silent pause in between section one and section two, and again, a silent pause in between section two and section three. They'll be real easy to pick out when it happens. It'll be music, and then stopping, and then music again. I'm not trying to talk down to you, I promise. I tried to write this out into the program, and the words are not great. So I thought I would take a second and just remind most of us that the reason that we do this is we are playing one composer's one entire thought, and it happens to have some pauses, but if there's applause in between, there's a good chance that our youthfulness may take over, and we may start thinking of other things, and there are very specific changes in our heads that need to happen in between these movements, and not like the applause isn't wanted and warranted. But if we could refrain from clapping in between first and second and third, and then tear the roof off at the end of the third movement. Thank you very much. Thank you so much for that. We would like to keep that in place for all concerts, but I'll remind you again later. Okay, so take a seat, you guys, for one other thing. So in the program, you were reading a little bit about the contest the next weekend. We've mentioned it a few times, titled The Concert After It. One of the things that I tried to explain to you was what happens after we get done playing on the stage in front of the three judges. It's called sight reading, and it's extremely nerve-wracking. It's hard to practice because you have to find some music that's of the level that they ask you to play, which is supposed to be two tiers lower than the music that you choose for your stage performance, okay? So imagine you've never seen this music, I've never seen the music, we walk into the room, there's a judge there that we may or may not know, and as you read in the program, the students get 4 minutes, that's it. Once the clock starts, that's all they have, okay? So you'll notice some section leaders doing some things like they may lead like a rhythm counting or a sizzle section or things like that. And unfortunately, we can never bring you into the sight reading room. It's OMEA rules, and we're not allowed to film, and we're not allowed to even audio tape. So to try to explain this to like parents at a Mentor Orchestra Association meeting whose students are very involved in orchestra, it can be a little tricky. So, as long as our symphony students are set, this doesn't involve you, symphony students. You'll just have to sit extremely quietly and not get as disqualified. But I thought tonight, live in front of you, we would just try it. I didn't tell them about this at all. Yeah. So I had my awesome colleagues, Ms. Driscoll and Mrs. Reyes, pick out a piece that I've never done in the level that we should be able to, should. We'll see how this goes. We're gonna start in just a second. No peeking, no peeking. You can pass them out, one per stand, but make sure they're face down. Let me know if you see any cheating out there. We'll nail them. As they finish passing this out, what can be very challenging about this is that we're not allowed to use our instruments. That's what we're comfortable doing. There's a reason why we didn't sign up for choir. And I, even though I taught choir for 6 years, you wouldn't want to hear the result of it. Are we almost there? Everyone's heart beating a little faster. We're really gonna do this. I did this one other year and it went really well, so I'm sure it will again. And there was no cheating today. I know the name of the piece, but I really don't know this, so we're about to really find out. I figure I'm not gonna mic them for their section, you'll just be able to hear. I'll start our 4 minutes in just a second. What you should notice is some section leaders getting up to lead a couple of things, and I think I've stalled enough. I'm not allowed to talk or interact with the students, but I'll be listening very carefully to what they do so that during my 4 minutes, I can hopefully correct them. Ready, go. Mentor Mannheim, you have 3 minutes remaining. Usually I have some post-it notes that I use to go through. I forgot them. I'm just going to have to wing it. Two minutes remains. Seconds. One minute. Seconds. Seconds. Ten seconds. Stop. Oh, the little game I play, I'm so close. So close. Okay, they have to stop talking. The judge will reset the timer. And then I get some time, and just to preface, after this is over, I'll move really quickly into actually performing, and while we play through the piece, I'm allowed to talk and sing and do things, which I may or may not do. We'll have to see how it goes. It's not normally what happens when we perform. I'm not usually a part of the noise making, but I will be today a little bit. Are we ready? Okay. First, before I start, let's go over here. Bring everyone with us. Okay. All right, you guys, we should be able to execute this well enough to really attack dynamics, all right? We're already talking about dynamic level. Tempo from the beginning is gonna be 1, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, and 4, you're on this side. 2, 3, and 4, and right? We've got a pretty good tempo there. Watch as we go into measure 9. Ooh, a solo. It's optional. Yeah, we're gonna do the solo. Yeah, so we'll do the solo, it's fair. No wasting time. And watch measure 13, that's where the 2D comes back in, okay? The key does not officially change, but we've got C naturals that creep in. No open E's, that will ruin the phrase. Make sure that the cellos don't fall into the trap of violin articulation. Those staccatos on 2 are in your part and your part only, be ready. Basses, I'll do the best to cue you, beat 4, bar 16, but yours are also very short, and that's a huge forte, okay? You are the only ones there that come in, and it's a big part. Make sure we keep tempo, but we have fluid bowing all the way through. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. Okay, it's gotta be really fluid. It can't be choppy. It changes dynamic often. Again, I can't stress enough fourth fingers. Do not play any open strings, we know this. Even A's and D's. Measure 24 is a page turn for me, okay? So I will take the writ. It'll be very, very small. Be ready to take tempo again at 25, and violas and cellos, don't get psyched out. You are on beat 2. Wait for that cue if I can catch it. I will take the same quality writ that I take in 31s, the one that I'm going to take in 24. Another solo. And then watch very carefully. I won't miss this pickup in the cellos and basses into the third bar. That's the cue for the 2D. The rest of us coming in at measure 35. Be really careful. 2 minutes remain. Again, cellos, measure 37, just like the previous passage. The fifth bar of the phrase always kind of gets a little bit more separated. Let's actually do this real quick from 33. Clap along with me, your parts. So we have a solo, and then we'll join 2D. Ready? 33 would be 1, 2, and ready. And 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and half, quarter, da, da. 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and da, 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 bum, ba, 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 bum, ba, di, da, 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 da. Good. Cellos, make sure that you really do take over in 37, especially 38, beat 4. 1, and 2, and 3, 4, and. Don't play 4, and, 4, and, okay? Watch measure 40. Espressivo, really let loose there. Connections more than we have in the rest of the piece. Really showcase to the judge that we're playing that very expressively different. Again, beat 2 entrance is very important. Keep everything really fluid throughout this section. Everybody shortens the bow strokes up at 53. Huge dynamic changes, everybody has them. Getting into 53 is a piano change. Into 55 is mezzo piano. It's a slow build, don't give away the surprise early. The biggest change in dynamic is 59 into 60. Then watch very carefully the writ and follow the 16ths and 62 only in the first and second violins. Then we will keep a slower tempo into 63. Everybody lifts going into 71, a cello rondo. Dynamic changes are halftime. And we're pretty much the same tempo in the beginning as we were in the end. More dynamic changes, and 1, 2, 3, 4, da, da, end. And I'll just give away 3 seconds, it's okay. All right, ready? Here we go. We're allowed to take an A, Manav. If you can give us an A, please.
The Mentor High School premiere of On an Eastern Shore by Alan Lee Silva. Thank you.
Yeah. We did pretty good on that. And nothing's ever perfect, obviously. There were things missed. You know, there are obvious range differences we can make, or one of those writs I just blew right past. It's okay, we'd get it the second time. But I think that was clearly enough, probably, for us. Thanks for sitting through that. It's good practice for us. Nice to have a National Merit Scholar soloist right there. That was kind of nice. Put him on the spot. He's used to this pressure. Nice work. How about another round for Mana? That's tough to do. And our Mannheim section leaders. And Mannheim, nice work, you guys. That was great. Thank you. So that'll be first. Definitely clap after that one. There's no movements there. Next, we'll be playing Genesis, a newer type piece written in the last few years. Oh, that's what it was. I wanted to mention, you may have been to a concert earlier this year and noticed some repeats. The classification that Mannheim and Symphony are both in, class AA, music is super hard. You can go see a lot of this played by professional groups all over the world. So we play a concert and then we hone in on some stuff and we'll have lots of new material for you at the end, including our final piece, which is a debut for us this evening.
Thank you.
Thanks again for coming out tonight. At DQ, see you at DQ afterwards. Always a fun orchestra fundraiser afterwards. If you're new to this, you have to tell your parents right afterwards, we deserve ice cream, take you there. And as long as you mention Mentor Orchestra tonight, they'll give a portion of the proceeds. To end this evening, we have the ultra famous Dance Bacchanal by Saint-Saëns. We have not played this one in a concert. I promise you'll love it, I guess. I can't really say that, but this is one of the pieces of music, if not the piece of music, that is probably why I'm standing here. I played it 23 years ago on this stage in a group in which I was with my future wife and a lot of my future friends. So Mannheim's been a great gift to me. Symphony's been a great gift to me. And we'll end this evening with Dance Bacchanal. Thanks again, everybody. Have a great night. See you at Dairy Queen. Think I know what we'll get, but I think I put in the program. We're always looking for ones. We're always looking to be superior rated. I think we got it. We'll see how it goes next week, you guys. Thank you so much. We'll see you then.